Good morning, children. Today's session, we are going to see the Big Bang answers for the 6th standard science. And the chapter is 4th chapter, The Living World of Plants. And page number 71, Roman number 1, choose the correct answer. First question is, pond is an example of dash ecosystem. Four options, A, marine, B, freshwater, C, deserts, and D, mountain. And the answer is B, freshwater. Question 2. The important function of stomata is dash. A, conduction, B, transpiration, C, photosynthesis, D, absorption. Answer is photosynthesis. Question 3. Organ of absorption is dash. A, root, B, stem, C, leaf, D, flower. So the correct answer is A, root. Question 4. The habitat of water hyacinth is A, aquatic, B, terrestrial, C, desert, and D, mountain. So the answer is A, aquatic. Next, Roman number 3, children, in the book. That is, fill in the blanks. Roman number 3 in the book, children. First one is, Earth's surface is covered by dash percent of water. That is more than 70% of water. The answer is more than 70%. Second, the driest places on Earth are deserts. Third, fixation and absorption are the main functions of root. Fourth, primary organs of photosynthesis are leaves. Fifth, taproot system is present in dicotyledonous plants. So what is the answer, children? Dicotyledonous plants. Then in the book, Roman number 2, children, true or false. So first one, plants can live without water. So the answer is false. So that plants cannot live without water is the correct answer, children. That is true. Plants cannot, instead of can, cannot should come. That is, cannot live without water. So the answer is false. Then question 2, all plants have chlorophyll. True. 3, plants have three parts, the root, stem, and leaves. So the answer is false. So the correct one is, plants have several parts such as the root, stem, leaves, flowers, fruits, and seeds. So it is false. Then question 4, mountain is an example for freshwater habitat. Answer is false. Actually, the correct one is, rivers, ponds, lakes, and pools are the examples of freshwater habitat, or either you can say mountain is an example for terrestrial habitats. Instead of freshwater, it's in a terrestrial is a correct one. Then question 5. Root is modified into spines. Answer is false. Leaves are modified into spines. Is the correct answer. Then question 6. Green plants need sunlight, and the answer is true. Match the following. So the first one is mountain. So the correct answer for that is Himalayas. Next one is desert. Answer is dry place. Third one, stem. Answer is branches. Fourth, photosynthesis. And the correct answer is leaves. And the fifth one, fibrous root. And the answer is monocot. Then Roman number 5, arrange in correct sequence. In first question is leaves, stem, root, flower. So this you have to arrange it in a correct order, children. So its correct order is root, stem, leaves, and flower. Question 2, transpiration, conduction, absorption, fixation. So the correct answer is fixation, absorption, conduction, and transpiration. Then Roman number 6, in the book it's given very short answer, children. So here is question 1. Classify the plants on the basis of their habitat. So the answer is, there are two major habitats, A, aquatic habitat, and B, terrestrial habitat. And A, aquatic habitat, classified into two. They are, first one, freshwater habitat, and the second, marine water habitat. Now B is terrestrial habitat. This is again classified into three. That is forest habitat, grassland habitat and desert habitat. Question 2. Identify the desert plants from the following: cactus, hydrilla, mango and rose. So cactus plants grow in deserts and are able to store water in the stem. So this is the identification. Since cactus plants grow in deserts and are able to store water in their stem. Then question 3. Define the term habitat. A dwelling place of an animal, plant or other organism to live and reproduce is called habitat. Question 4. Relate the terms leaves and photosynthesis. Leaves are green in color. They have chlorophyll and do photosynthesis. Next, Roman number 7. In the book, it's given short answer, children. So the first question is, why do you call jasmine plant a twiner? So the answer is, jasmine plant has weak stem. It cannot stand straight on its own. So it must climb on any support to survive. So jasmine plant is called as a twiner. Then second, compare the taproot and fibrous root system. So the comparison is, taproot, it's a single root which grows straight with smaller roots arise from the taproot. Example, dicot plants and it's a bean and mango. And for the fibrous root, cluster of roots arise from the base of the stem, thin and uniform in size. Example, monocots, grass and paddy. Third question, distinguish between terrestrial and aquatic habitats. So the answer is, first we'll see the terrestrial habitats. They are found on land. They include desert, grassland, forest, farms, towns and cities. And they're classified into three types, such as desert habitat, grassland habitat and forest habitat. And the example is rubber tree, teak tree and neem tree. Next is the aquatic habitats. They are found in water. They include the areas permanently as well as occasionally covered by water. They are classified into two types, such as freshwater habitat and marine water habitat. Example, lily, lotus, marine algae and sea grasses. And the fourth question, list out the plants present in your school garden. Answer is show flower, ferns, crotons, roses, lilies, cactus, coconut trees, royal palm, clitoria, cycas, agave, alamanda, tomato, brinjal, lady's finger, etc. in terrace garden. Then Roman number 8, page number 72, children. Let's answer in detail. First one, make a list of the functions of root and stem. So first we'll see functions of root. The root fixes the plant to the soil, absorbs water and minerals from the soil, stores food in some plants like carrot and beetroot. And the functions of stem, the stem supports the branches, leaves, flowers and fruits, transport water and minerals from roots to upper aerial plant parts, transports the prepared food from leaves to the other parts, and stores food as in the case of sugarcane. Study the given concept, ma'am. This is a question 2. Connect them, correcting by drawing arrow marks. Complete the map by filling the blanks. So the first one, habitat, this is classified into two, that is aquatic and terrestrial. So again, this aquatic we'll see now, that is they are again classified into freshwater and marine. And the terrestrial, the blank you have to write. Terrestrial is divided into, classified into two, children, that is desert. A grassland is already given there. So in the next fill up, you have to write that desert. Then we'll see the freshwater now, it's again classified into two, that is river and lake and pond. Okay, children, river, lake, pond. So again, terrestrial is classified into three again, desert, forest and grassland, children. So did you understand this, children? That is again also your habitat classified into two, that is aquatic and terrestrial. Aquatic classified into two, that is freshwater and marine. Then terrestrial classified into desert, forest and grassland. Freshwater is again classified into three, that is river, already given there. So pond and lake you have to write there, children. Do you understand this, children? Yes, thank you.
முடியல.